I suppose have some games.
Hey guys, welcome back to Classic G Body Garage. Working on the interior, putting the interior together on the 78 Cal AT Top. Sitting back behind here are the bucket seats that are going to go into this car. And I am finally to that point. If you guys have been watching this build, I went ahead and cleaned the floor, put down some used carpet, decent used carpet, rebuilt the console, and put the interior back together up to the point of the bucket seats. Now this car, if you check out the first videos of this car, it had Firebird seats in it, which were incorrect, but they did use the G-Body seat tracks. Now these bucket seats here are out of the 78 Cutlass Supreme parts car that had the 403 in it. Now, fortunately, I hung on to these seats. They weren't the greatest of condition. They're pretty dirty, as you can see, but definitely very cleanable and very usable. They do have a little tear right there, but that's not really that bad. So, and also the seat bottom is broke. This plastic piece sitting here is broke on the passenger seat here. You can see that it's right here, and then on this side it's completely missing. So, you know, this piece, I've had this piece for probably over 20 years because I parted out a car back in the 90s, a white Cutlass Calais with blue bucket seats. And I grabbed the seats out of that car. They were all torn to shreds, but I parted the seats out because I used the reclining mechanisms. Now, these are not reclining seats, but I used the reclining mechanisms and I kept the seat bottoms. So wouldn't you guess that a part that I've had sitting around for 20 years, probably over 20 years, I'm gonna put it to good use, and it's even the color that I need. And hey, it's even faded the same way these seats are. So enough on the seats. I did a little bit more work to the interior from the last video that you guys saw. I finished bolting the seat bolt or the seat belts down, put the bucket seat seat belts in place. I put the kick panel in place, polished up the sill plate, and also put the B-pillar piece back into place. And Moby's inside once again. This is a different day, different time than all my last videos, but yet every time I open the doors of these cars, he comes in and makes himself right at home. So I still have to get the put the kick panel in on the passenger side there, polish up that sill plate, and install that as well. So I'm going to go ahead and start taking these seats apart, replace this lower bottom piece on the driver's seat here, and go ahead and bolt on the seat tracks that I took off the Firebird seats that are sitting here in the mess that's in the trunk. So I'm going to be cleaning up some of this stuff as well and using up some of these parts. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. All right, well, I lost my son, but fortunately the seats are dry. Scrubbed them down, and this is as good as they are going to get. Looks like they have some staining, you can see here on the passenger seat, but overall these things came pretty clean. I went ahead, like you saw, replaced the backing of the driver's seat. So that's all nice and repaired there. No more busted up seat. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these inside the car. All right, the bucket seats are in and the T-tops are off. I figured I'd take the T-tops off just for a little bit of visual effect. Give you guys a better look at what the interior looks like with all that sunshine pouring in. At least, well, it's not that sunny, but hey, I'm in Northern Ohio, so it doesn't get all that sunny here. But hey, it is nice to have the T-tops off if you have a T-top G-body. So this is how it looks. Considering what I had to work with, it really doesn't look all that bad. If you guys remember what it looked like prior with those nasty Firebird seats and the carpet that had green moss growing in here just because it was so damp. So fortunately I was able to get to it, kind of rescue the interior, clean it all out, get the floorboards back into shape, and keep everything nice and dry in here. So overall it doesn't look bad considering it is 35 year old interior. You know, some of these cars, they just didn't last at all. So I'm glad I'm at least saving this one, or at least trying to. So lower door panels, I do have the dark blue door panels, so I'll go ahead and swap those out and it'll tie everything in nicely with the lower panels that I have right there. So we'll have nice lower dark blue interior that'll go along with the dark blue carpet as well. So there you go. I guess I'll get another set of floor mats for this car. I did try to salvage the original General Motors floor mats that that came out of the Cutlass that I snagged this carpet from, but you can see the carpet is changing colors differently than the floor mats. So I'll see if I can get a good set of floor mats for this car, make it look a little bit better. Got the sill plate in place, polished up. Let me walk around the other side and you can see what the driver's side looks like. And I'll continue doing some cleaning. The steering column as well, it's kind of messed up. So I'll be doing a video on the steering column because the buzzer won't stop buzzing. And you can see someone had this column apart prior just because the little filler piece that goes back in there is missing. And it just doesn't feel right when you turn the keys. So someone had it apart, probably to replace the tumbler at one time because that looks like a newer key. So, and I will also be doing a gauge cluster video. And I know that I've mentioned in the past that I'd be doing one of these videos, and because you know these old gauge clusters, they do act up, they quit working, the tack starts jumping all over the place, and the four little gauges right there in the front, they all start jumping around or they don't work. So I'll show you guys how to fix that, and that's the reason why the dash is partly apart, because I have to get going on that. So there you go, the interior is together. Got to do a few odds and ends, like I said, with the interior panels or the lower door panels, but overall we're looking pretty good. The interior is clean, dry, smelling good, and that's probably the biggest thing. This thing just smelled like a moldy pile of shit. So overall we're looking pretty good. So there you have it. Keep those comments coming. If you like what you see, subscribe. If you love G-bodies, subscribe in general. I have all sorts of stuff going on. So like I always say guys, I will be talking to you in the next classic G-body garage video.